Welcome to BrainFeed Magazine. From this article, you will learn about highlights of the 28th Conference of the Parties to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, COP28. Let's get started. The 28th Conference of the Parties to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, COP28, was held in Dubai from 30th November to 12th December. With nearly 200 countries participating, the conference aimed to accelerate action towards achieving the goals of the Paris Agreement. The Paris Agreement included limiting global temperature rise to 1.5 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels and building resilience to climate impacts. So, was COP28 a triumph for the planet or a disappointing stumble on the path to a sustainable future? Antonio Guterres, Secretary General, United Nations, cautioned the world right at the onset of his speech just days ago, "I was on the melting ice of Antarctica. Not long before, I was among the melting glaciers of Nepal." He also added, "These two spots are far in distance, but united in crisis. Polar ice and glaciers are vanishing before our eyes, causing havoc the world over, from landslides and floods to rising seas. But this is just one symptom of the sickness bringing our climate to its knees, a sickness only you, global leaders, can cure." Key outcomes of COP28. Fossil fuel reckoning. A majority of countries acknowledged the central role of fossil fuels in driving climate change, which sets the stage for phasing out these harmful fuels and transitioning to clean energy sources like renewables. Global stocktake. A comprehensive evaluation of progress towards Paris Agreement goals revealed that the current trajectory falls short of keeping global warming within the crucial 1.5 degrees Celsius limit. An agreement was reached to conduct a comprehensive assessment of progress towards the Paris Agreement goals every 5 years. Fast-tracking emissions cuts. Countries agreed to significantly increase their ambition on emission reductions, with a tripling of renewable energy targets and a doubling of energy efficiency goals. Boosting climate finance, COP28 saw a significant increase in pledges to the Green Climate Fund, a critical source of financing for climate action in developing countries. Addressing loss and damage, a new operational plan for the Warsaw International Mechanism for Loss and Damage was adopted, providing practical support for countries already facing the consequences of a warming planet. Additional highlights of COP28. The hosting of the summit in the oil-producing UAE has drawn criticism, as has the country's decision to name Sultan Al Jaber, CEO of state oil firm ADNOC, as COP28 president. Jaber has made a point of including the fossil fuel industry at the summit, insisting that oil and gas companies should be part of discussions on tackling climate change. The president of COP28, Sultan Al Jaber, has claimed there is no science indicating that a phase-out of fossil fuels is needed to restrict global heating to 1.5 degrees Celsius. Activists protested over the presence of the oil, gas, and coal industry at the COP28 UN summit in Dubai while demanding an end to the use of fossil fuels, which are the major source cause of climate change. Challenges and opportunities. The agreed-upon emissions cuts are still not enough to keep the 1.5 degree goal within reach, and concrete implementation plans are urgently needed. The increased ambition on emissions reductions, the focus on adaptation and loss and damage, and the strengthened commitment to climate finance demonstrate a growing global understanding of the urgency of the climate crisis. Looking ahead, the success of COP28 will ultimately be measured by the actions taken in the years to come. Governments, businesses, and individuals must now translate their commitments into concrete steps that will bend the emissions curve and build resilience to climate impacts. COP28 has provided a roadmap for a more sustainable future, but it is only the first step on a long and challenging journey. That brings us to the end of this article. Here you learned. COP28 in Dubai aimed to accelerate climate action with outcomes including acknowledgement of fossil fuels' role, increased emissions reduction ambition, and a boost in climate finance. Despite progress, challenges remain, such as the need for concrete implementation plans to achieve the 1.5-degree goal and the inclusion of the fossil fuel industry in climate discussions. The conference highlights a growing global understanding of the urgency of the climate crisis, emphasizing the importance of translating commitments into action for a sustainable future. We hope you like this story. Stay tuned to BrainFeed TV, our YouTube channel.